Hey guys, I am super excited to show you how you can create an awesome looking colorful glassmorphism kind of a motion graphics design, which is super easy to create inside of DaVinci Resolve without using any third-party plugins or anything else. This is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's get started. Alright, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 17 edit page, and before we get started we have to do some basic setting. So click on this setting button right over here and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. You can go with 4K as well. You can select the resolution from here, and now we have to select a frame rate. So in this case I am using this 30 frame per second, but you can select 60 frame per second for a smooth animation, or you can just keep it 24 frame per second for cinematic. All right, and then you can click on save. Now we have to create this animation inside of this fusion page. So we have to take a new fusion composition. So just go to this media pool. If you don't have this media pool, then you can click on this media pool button and right click on this media pool, click on this new fusion composition, and you can call it anything, it doesn't really matter. And we have to set the duration of this composition, maybe 10 seconds long, frame rate 30, and click on create. And then we have to drag this fusion composition on this timeline just like this, and now you can go on this fusion page, and inside of this fusion page we will get this media out node. So just drag this media out to the side for now, and we need only one viewer for this animation. So you can click on this single viewer, and now we have only one viewer. All right, and after that let's start by creating a background. So click on this background button to add a background on this flow window. Drag this background to the viewer, and as you can see this is the black background, so we need a white background for this animation. So just go to this inspector window and let's select a white color, and now we have a white background. All right, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, and you can call it background. Hit OK, and after that let's create multiple colorful circular shapes. So we have to take a new background node, and this is going to be the color. So hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, or you can also right click on this background and click on rename, and you can call it color. Hit OK, drag this color to the viewer, and you can pick any color. So for this one I'm going to use this sky blue color. Hit OK, and now we have to attach ellipse mask with this. So this is the ellipse tool. Let's drag this ellipse on this flow window and attach this ellipse with the color background, and we will get something like this. Select this ellipse, hit F2, and let's call it ellipse. And now let's downsize a bit and place the circle just like this, and after that we have to animate the circle. So select the color output and add a transform node with this. By using this transform we can animate the circle. So just drag this transform to the viewer, hit F2 to rename, and you can call it transform. All right, and after that let's animate the circle. So just go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 30 frame per second. Go to inspector window after selecting this transform node, right click on center, click on animate, and lock this value on this frame number 60, and then go to on frame number 240, which is equal to 8 seconds according to 30 frame per second, and again we have to lock this value. So you can right click on this center, click on set key, or you can also click on this time on button to add a keyframe. All right, and then go to the end of this animation, maybe on frame number 300, and let's drag the circle outside of this frame in upper direction just like this, and then just go to very first frame of this animation, and here we have to drag it down and set it like this, and we will get something like this. Now we have to add little animation between these two keyframes. So just go to on frame number 150, which is equal to 5 seconds middle of this animation, and you can drag the circle up or down just a little bit. All right, and now you can play the animation. So as you can see, it's looking very weird because it's a linear animation. So we have to make it smoother. Just go to a spline window by clicking on this spline, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. You can increase the size of this spline window. Let's minimize the transform. Check this transform to active all the keyframes. Click on fit button. And as you can see, we have all the keyframes. And after that, select all the keyframes by dragging like this. Hit S on the keyboard to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button. And after that, just go to very first keyframe right over here on frame number 0. Hold this handle and let's create a nice and simple smooth curve. Just like this. And then go to the end of this animation on this last keyframe. Hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. And you can keep this handle straight just like this. And then go to very first frame and let's take a look. And as you can see, we have a smooth animation and it's looking perfect. Now just close the spline window, increase the preview window just like this. You can click on fit button and we have to create multiple copy of this circle. So how to do that? It's very simple. Just select all the transform node, right click on that. Click on copy, or you can also hit Ctrl C on the keyboard to copy, and double click on this blank area, hit Ctrl V to paste, and we will get another copy. And after that, we have to merge this output with this transform. So it's very simple. Just connect the output of this transform 1 with this transform and we will get this merge 1. Just drag this merge 1 to the viewer. Now you can move the circle. You can make it a little bit smaller, place it like this, and you can change the color. So select the color 1, and for this one I'm gonna select this color. Hit OK. You can select any color that you like. And after that, we have to create one more copy. So hit Ctrl V on the keyboard to paste, and now let's connect the output of this transform with this merge 1 and we will get another merge. Place it like this and drag it to the viewer. And now select the ellipse, drag it and place it right over here. And you can make it a little bit smaller. And now just select the color 2 and select any color that you like. So I'm gonna select this purple color. All right, and now let's make one more. Hit Ctrl V on the keyboard. And let me show you how you can merge these output in another way. So it's very simple. You can take a new merge just like this. You can use this output as a background and this output as a foreground. So connect the yellow background point with this output and green foreground point with this output. Just drag this merge 3 to the viewer. All right, and now select the color 3 and you can select any different color, maybe green. Hit OK. And now select the ellipse and you can place anywhere in the frame. And now you can arrange these just like this. All right, and after that, let's add one more circle right over here and right over here. So let's make one more. Hit Ctrl V to paste. Attach this output with this merge 3 and just drag this merge 4 to the viewer. Select this ellipse. Let's drag it down and place it over here maybe. Select this color node and pick this yellow color. You can select any color as you know. And now hit Ctrl V to paste. Let's connect this output with this one. Drag this merge 5 to the viewer. Select this ellipse. Let's drag it down a little bit and place it right over here. You can select any color that you like, just like this. All right, and Now I want to create time gap between each circles. So what we have to do, let's go to the spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. Let's increase the size of this, and we have all the transform nodes. So let's minimize all the transforms. Just keep it first one and uncheck all the transform node, just like this. Click on fit button. And now I want to create time gap of 3 frames between each circles. So just go to very first frame of this animation, maybe on frame number 0, and then just go to 3 frames forward in time on frame number 3. Just leave the first one as it is and check the second one. Select these 3 keyframes, hold this keyframe and just drag it on frame number 3. Alright, and do the same thing for this one, but in opposite direction. So just go to 3 seconds back in time, maybe on 297 frame. Select these 2 keyframes and just move it like this, and do the same process for all the transform node. So let me show you how you can do this. Just go to on this keyframe, maybe on frame number 3, and from here we have to move 3 frame forward in time. So just go to on frame number 6, as you can see. And for this one, let's uncheck this transform 1, check this transform 2, and again select these 3 keyframes, move it on frame number 6, and just go to the end of this animation and go to 6 frame back in time, maybe on frame number 294. Select these 2 keyframes and just move it on this keyframe. All right, and now we have to repeat same thing, so I'm going to do this in fast forward. All right, so it's done, and now you can close the spline window. Just let's increase the preview window just like this and go to very first frame and let's have a look. Alright, so as you can see, it's looking very interesting. And now we have to do one more thing. Just select the final output, hit Ctrl plus a space bar for search box and search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow effect, hit add button. And now just drag this drop shadow to the viewer. We have to change the color of the shadow. So let's set the blue value 0.5. Now it's looking perfect. And let's decrease the shadow strength, maybe 0.25, and increase the blur value and set it 1. All right, and after that we have to increase the scale of these circles. So what we have to do, just select the shadow and place it right over here, attach a transform node with this drop shadow just like this, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, and this is going to be size. So let's call it size, drag this to the viewer. Let's increase the size of these circles. So let's set the value 1.25, and you can keep it in center just like this. All right, and now we have to merge these circles with the white background. So this is the white background. Let's drag it over here and let's take a new merge node. I'm going to use this background as a background and this output as a foreground. So connect the yellow background point with this background and green foreground point with the size, and drag this merge 6 to the viewer, and we will get something like this, which is looking awesome. All right, and now let's create glass morphism effect. So it's very simple. Just select the final output, hit Ctrl plus a space bar for search box, and search for Gaussian blur. So this is the Gaussian blur effect, hit add button and drag this Gaussian blur to the viewer. Let's increase the blur value and set this value 0.8, and it's looking like this. And after that we have to attach a rectangular mask with this. So this is the rectangle button, add this rectangle, hit F2, call it rectangle, and attach this rectangle with this Gaussian blur. Let's increase the size of this rectangle. So let's set the width value 0.7, height value 0.6. And you can increase the corner radius. I'm going to set the value 0.2. And we will get something like this. After that, let's take one more background node. So we have the background, hit F2, and this is going to be the whiteness. So let's call it whiteness. Let's merge this whiteness with the final output, just like this. And now select the whiteness and set the white color. And after that, let's attach same rectangle with this whiteness. So select the rectangle, hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V to paste. And now let's attach this rectangle with this whiteness, select the merge 7, and let's down the blending value and set the blend value 0.1. All right, and you can see the effect before and after. All right, it's looking much more better. And now let's add one more background node. So let's take a new background, and this background is going to be a stroke. So hit F2 on the keyboard to rename. Let's call it a stroke. Hit OK. Now let's merge this stroke with this final output. So connect the stroke output with this final output, and we will get another merge. Let's drag this merge to the viewer. Select the stroke, and again we have to select white color. Hit OK. And now we have to add same rectangle with this stroke. So hit Ctrl V to paste and attach this rectangle with this stroke. And after that, select the rectangle and just go to inspector window, and here we have to uncheck the solid, and let's increase the border width. So I'm going to set this value 0.0005. All right. And as you can see, we will get a little edges around this rectangle. All right, it's looking perfect. And after that, you can click on fit, and we have to add a text right over here. You can add anything that you like. So I'm going to add a text. Just take a new text node, attach the output of this text with the final output, and we will get this merge. Just drag this merge to the viewer, select the text and type anything that you like. You can select any font style. So I'm going to use this font style Android, which is my favorite font style. You can increase the size. So I'm going to set the value 0.125. Perfect. Now you can decrease the line spacing. I'm going to set this value 0.85. And now it's looking like this. And finally, it's almost done. So we have to connect the media out node with this final output, just like this. All right, you can click on fit button, and as you can see, our animation is ready for render. And then you can go to the edit page, and here you can see we have the nice and simple animation that you can use as an intro or anything else that you want. You can turn on the loop button, and let me show you how you can create multiple slides. So it's very simple. Just select the fusion composition, hit Ctrl C to copy, place the CTI at the end of this, hit Ctrl V to paste, just place the CTI on the second one, go to fusion page, and here you can change the text. Just like this. You can change the color by yourself from here. So we have all the color nodes. You can select any different color and create different combination, and then go to the edit page, and now we have the multiple slides. So just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.